Hello, everyone. This is ASM Art Books, and today we'll be having a look at the Sleepy Book. This is not an art book, it's a bedtime story. A sleepy, sleepy bedtime story that was one of my favorites when I was little. It belonged to my sister, so I don't want you to see her name. We've got a little kitty all curled up asleep. And this is made up of just a few short little stories and poems. And the first story is The Whispering Rabbit. Once there was a sleepy little rabbit who began to yawn, and he yawned, and he yawned, and he yawned. He opened his little rabbit mouth when he yawned, till you could see his white front teeth and his little round pink mouth. And he yawned, and he yawned, until suddenly a bee flew into his mouth. Swallowed the bee. "Hoo, hoo," said a fat old owl. "Always keep your paw in front of your mouth when you yawn." Hooted the owl. "Rabbits never do that," said the sleepy little rabbit. "Silly rabbits," said the owl, and he flew away. The little rabbit was just calling after him, but when the little rabbit opened his mouth to speak, the bumblebee had curled up to sleep in his throat, and all he could do was whisper. "What shall I do?" he whispered to a squirrel who wasn't sleepy. "Wake him up," said the squirrel. "Wake up," the bumblebee. "How?" whispered the rabbit. "All I can do is whisper. Sleepy, and I want to go to sleep. And who can sleep with a bumblebee?" Suddenly, a wise old groundhog popped up out of the ground. "All I can do is whisper," said the little rabbit. "All the better," said the groundhog. "Come here, little rabbit," he said, "and I will whisper to you how to wake up a bumblebee. The rabbit. "Too loud," said the groundhog, and popped back into his hole. "A little noise," whispered the rabbit, and he started making little rabbit noises. He made a sound as quiet as the sound of a bird's wing cutting the air, but the bee didn't wake up. So the little rabbit made the sound of snow falling, but the bee didn't wake up. So the little rabbit made the sound of a bug breathing, and a fly sneezing, and grass rustling, and a fireman thinking. Still, the bee didn't wake up. So the rabbit sat and thought of all the little sounds he could think of. What could they be? A sound quiet as snow melting, quiet as a flower growing, quiet as an egg. Quiet as, and suddenly he knew the little noise that he would make, and he made it. It was a little click made hundreds of miles away by a bumblebee in an apple tree in full bloom on a mountaintop. It was the very small click of a bee swallowing some honey from an apple blossom. And at that, the bee woke up. He thought he was missing something, and away he flew. And then what did the little rabbit do? That sleepy, sleepy little rabbit. closed his mouth, he closed his eyes, he closed his ears, he tucked in his paws, and twitched his nose, and went sound asleep. There he is, asleep. Now we have a rabbit poem. Nobody knows a rabbit's nose, the way it twitches, the way it goes, constantly on his face. Nobody knows a rabbit's ears, the way he listens and what he hears, and his sad little rabbit tears. Nobody knows a rabbit's eyes, red as rubies without surprise, and his square fur face. And now we have a song, All the Pretty Little Horses. I'm not going to attempt to sing it to you, maybe sometime in the future, but not today. So I'll just read it like a poem. Go to sleep, go to sleep, go to sleep, you little baby. When you wake, you shall have all the pretty little horses, black and gray, dapple and bay. All the pretty little horses. Mother loves you. Daddy loves you. Everybody loves baby. The butterflies and flies are buzzing around your eyes. So go to sleepy little baby. And after you sleep, I'll give you a jeep. And all the pretty little horses. Black and bay. And gray, all the pretty little horses. Mother loves you, Daddy loves you, everybody loves baby. And they have the notes if you don't know the melody. Okay, and this is a little poem called Close Your Eyes. Reminds me of that now infamous book, Go With the F to Sleep, if you've heard of that. This is like the clean version almost. Little donkey on the hill, standing there so very still, making faces at the skies. Little donkey, close your eyes. Silly sheep that slowly crop, night has come and you must stop. Chewing grass beneath the skies. Silly sheep, now close your eyes. Little monkey in a tree, swinging there so merrily, throwing coconuts at the skies. Little monkey, close your eyes. Little birds that sweetly sing, curve your heads beneath your wing. No more whistling in the skies. Little birds, now close your eyes. Horses in your stall, stop your stomping, stop it all. Tails stop twitching after flies. Little horses, close your eyes. Little pigs that snuff about, no more snorting with your snout. No more squealing to the skies. Noisy pigs, now close your eyes. Old black cat down in the barn, keeping four black kittens warm. Winds are quiet in the skies. Dear old black cat, close your eyes. Little child, all tucked in bed, looking like a sleepy head. Stars are quiet in the skies. Little child, now close your eyes. Little donkey, close your eyes. Silly sheep, now close your eyes. Little monkey, close your eyes. Little bird, close your eyes. Little horses, close your eyes. Noisy pigs, now close your eyes. Dear old black cat, close your eyes. Little child, now close your eyes. Going to sleep. All over the world, the animals are going to sleep. The birds and the bees, the horse, the butterfly, and the cat. by the ocean, the fishhawks are going to sleep. And how does a young fishhawk go to sleep? The same as any other bird in the world. She folds her wings and pushes herself deep in the nest, looks around, and blinks her eyes 3 times, takes one long last look over the ocean, then tucks her head under her wing and sleeps like a bird. And the fish in the sea sleep in the darkened sea when the long green light of the sun is gone. And they sleep like fish, with their eyes wide open in some quiet current of the sea. And above and beyond, under the stars on the land, all the little horses are going to sleep. Some stand up in the still dark fields, and some fold their legs under them and lie down. But they all go to sleep like horses. Even the bees and the butterflies sleep when the moths begin to fly. And they sleep like bees and butterflies, under a leaf or a stick or a stone, with folded wings and their eyes wide open. For fish and bees and butterflies never close their shiny eyes. And the old fat bear in the deep dark woods goes into his warm cave to sleep for a whole winter. And so do the groundhogs and the hedgehogs, the skunks and the black-eyed raccoons. They eat a lot, then sleep until spring. A long, warm sleep. We've got Mr. Sleepy Raccoon. The end of this little golden book, the sleepy book. I hope it made you nice and sleepy, and thank you for watching. Have a good night.